Welcome to Greedy for Green. I have a little problem in my plant heaven right now. My jade plant has, you know, started getting infestation of a little mealybug. This is the same jade plant that I ordered 2 months back from Ugao, and you know, I started noticing little white mealybugs. If we are all gardeners, we know that, you know, our plants, indoor plants tend to get, even outdoor plants tend to get mealybugs. So I have developed a little system of mine to, you know, fight these small pesky pests, which otherwise are a little tough to get rid of. And also if your jade plant, it is also known as elephant bush, if your jade plant has mealybugs, you know, it's a bit tricky because the leaves are small and the branches are intricate. So I have developed this process, which is a 4-step process: the unpotting, then the inspection, then the treatment, and the third is repotting. When I repot, I will change the potting mix, because this plant has got the mealybug in the potting mix which it came from Ugao. So I am going to change it. Maybe it's not happy in the potting mix, so I have to change the potting mix and also make sure it's getting the required nutrients so that there is no further attack of mealybugs in the near future. So let's go dive into the steps.
So this is my jade plant. As you can see, the potting mix is still the one which it came in. The topping is of sphagnum moss. Often the sphagnum moss topping, you know, causes increased water retention in the roots, and that can also be a cause of mealy attack. Let's unpot. See, there are dried leaves. I'll give you a closer look of where the mealybug infestation has happened. There, healthy roots. We know how to like massage lightly and loosen the roots up. Be very careful not to hurt the roots when doing this process. There, you can see the root ball is intact, and let's move on to the inspection. Take a sharp object. I'm taking a scissor because you have to go inside and, you know, inspect the inner corners of the leaves and the bush wherever there is infestation. I'll show you where. Oh my god, what did you see? I think it's a spider mite in a little web. Yeah, there. It's a spider mite in a little web that was sitting right in my jade plant. Okay, let's move on to the mealybugs. Where is the mealy? See the white spots. I don't know if you can see the white spots. There, the white one. It's at the base of a stem. And yeah, there is a little mealybug underneath the leaf also. So, in order to get better access, I will just clip off the stem. Don't worry, they will grow back. But right now, you need to get rid of the mealybugs. See, like I'm doing, get rid of the stem so that you get better access there. The white part, I'll show you. There, did that one. Yeah, there. There. So I get rid of the stem at the base of which the bugs are developing. And we move on to the treatment part. This is what I'm going to use. It is detergent water, plain detergent water, nothing else. We all have detergent in our home. And I'm going to take a brush and just spot fix, like attack right on the spot of where the mealybug is growing. Underneath the leaves also. If you're a painter, you'll be able to do this properly. Do not do it very sharply or harshly, because the leaves are soft, they can just chop off. So you know, light touches like this is good enough. And if your infestation is very heavy, mine is light, little spots, but if your infestation is heavy, you will have to repeat this process every 3 to 4 days. But like for light spot management, you can go like this. I'll observe this for 2 to 3 days, and if I see that the mealybugs are reappearing, I'll do this process again. But for the first sitting, you go like this. Yes, all the leaves underneath the leaves right there. See that I did not miss any. Because the infestation started at the bottom, I am going a little heavy at the bottom and just splashing and sprinkling little bit at the top. It's done. Let's move on to the next step. Okay, this is the potting mix that I have prepared. It has 2.5 part cocoa peat and 1/2 part garden soil. These white balls are perlite, 2 tablespoons, and I'm going to add this fungicide powder along with this potting mix, because my jade plant is under stress right now, so it needs to be protected from fungal attack. So let's mix it well, and I'm going to use the same pot. I've washed it properly. Always before repotting, wash your pot properly. I'm not putting any pebbles underneath, because this is a self-watering pot and the water travels up through the holes beneath through transpiration. Placing the plant right now, like this potting mix is going to be a lot more light, and it's going to have a lot better aeration than the previous one because it has perlite. So that's why I have added the perlite in it, and I'm like filling this pot hole. I'm not leaving any gap at the top, because some of the cocoa peat will drain out from the bottom holes. So I'm just filling the pot hole. So there, the potting is done. Moving on to the watering. Water the plant properly and sufficiently from the top, so as to wash the detergent water which we use to treat the mealybug. Water every leaf properly and water the potting mix properly. Always sprinkle like this, never like pour water. It's very important to water a plant after repotting it, because it minimizes the stress that the plant is going through. There, getting rid of the dry leaves. My jade plant is, I hope it's free of mealybugs. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to Greedy for Green for more such videos. Thank you. Bye.